Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel Skills to Scale. Listen Mahabharata in Simple English by Shruti Bhushan. In the previous video, we have seen the death of Duryodhana and the havoc created by Ashwatthama. If you haven't watched the previous video, please watch it. And also like, share and subscribe to Skills to Scale to get more videos. The next day, when the Pandavas returned, they saw only ashes left of the entire camp. When a surviving soldier briefed them of the incident, their rage was boundless. They set immediately in search of Ashwatthama and found him under a tree. A fight picked up between them and Ashwatthama. And then Ashwatthama hurled the Brahmastra at Arjuna. Arjuna retaliated with the same astra. Terrified, sage Vedavyasa rushed to the spot and warned them that the collision will destroy the whole world. Arjuna summoned the astra back before it could cause a mass destruction. But Ashwatthama had no clue how to retrieve it back and he made it worse. He directed it to Uttara's womb, killing the successor of the Pandavas. Krishna took away Ashwatthama's gem and cursed him of immortality. Immortality is the greatest boon a man can ever earn. But for Ashwatthama, it was a curse that he would roam the earth with blood and injuries and would search for death for relief from the pain in all yugas. There would not have been a cruel curse ever. Krishna later revived the Abhimanyu's child with his powers, who came to be known as Parikshit Maharaj, who succeeded Yudhishthira to the throne of Hastinapur. The war thus ended with very little of life surviving. Victory came to the Pandavas, not without any loss. The Pandavas returned to Hastinapur. They took the blessings of the elders at the palace. Dhritarashtra blessed each of his nephews, but he was looking for someone. Krishna, realizing Dhritarashtra's intention, pushed the iron statue before it was Bhima's turn. Dhritarashtra hugged the statue, thinking it was Bhima, released all his anger in his embrace and crushed the statue. Not able to bear the strength of Dhritarashtra, the statue collapsed and broke into pieces. His arm started bleeding. Dhritarashtra realized his foolishness and began to cry at his action. Krishna consoled him and mentioned it was not Bhima and just a mere statue. Relieved, he blessed Bhima. It was Gandhari's turn. Since she knew the war was Duryodhana's stupidity, she blessed the Pandavas. But her son's death did not leave the mother with no fire. When Yudhishthira bent to seek her blessings, a small fraction of her anger was released from a small gap in the cloth tied around her eyes that chilled Yudhishthira's toe. This was only a small fraction. However, she completely fled upon Krishna. She felt that Krishna was the reason for the removal of her entire clan. She cursed Krishna that the entire Yadava clan will be destroyed like hers. Krishna merely smiled. He knew that no one could defeat the Yadavas and they would fight amongst themselves to bring upon their own destruction. Yudhishthira's coronation ceremony was held in grandeur. After becoming the king of Hastinapur, the Pandavas went to meet their grandsire at Kurukshetra. Bhima advised him on the political, social and economical strategies that can help a kingdom flourish. During the sacred period of Uttarayanam, Bhishma breathed his last. Yudhishthira ruled the kingdom with his able brothers and in his just rule, the kingdom proposed and happiness prevailed. Dhritarashtra, Gandhari, Kunti and Vidura set out to the forest to spend their last days by leading an ascetic life. 36 years from then, Gandhari's curse came true and the Yadava clan destroyed themselves completely. When Krishna was resting under a tree, a hunter mistook his foot for an animal and fired an arrow. The arrow pierced its way, leading to the end of the ninth incarnation of Lord Vishnu. Thus, the great Mahabharata happened and ended. Anyone who reads, watches and listens this epic will be blessed and have all their sins washed away. Finally, I have been singularly fortunate to have completed the God's work of narrating the holy epic Mahabharata in simple English for the benefit of the current generation in 60 stories. Thanks a lot and best wishes and regards to the viewers of the channel for your kind patronage. This is Shruti Bhushan signing off. Thank you.